Now I'm going to show you how to set up Visual Studio Code with C++. If you prefer, use Visual Studio Code, of course. Well, first of all, we need the Visual Studio Tools. We need to download that so we can run and compile our C++ project. Basically, is that. If you have already downloaded the Microsoft Visual Studio IDE, you don't have to download its build tools because it is already integrated in Microsoft Visual Studio IDE. So, to install the Microsoft build tools, we hit the development desktop with C++ and we go ahead and install. If you want another resources, you can choose. If you want to make C sharp or something, maybe you can choose. And as you can see, since I've already downloaded Microsoft Studio IDE, I will not need Visual Studio Build Tools. So I'm going to pause the download and to remove the Microsoft Build Tools from my setup. But if you don't have the IDE, go ahead, install the Visual Studio Build Tools, and you are fine with it. Now, our tools to compile and run C++ code are fine. We are going to download Visual Studio Code. We're gonna wait for download to finish. Now the download is finished, we click in the executable. We accept the agreement and we do next. I'm gonna change the location installation of Visual Studio Code, but you can keep the location as it is on default. We go hit next, 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 and install. Let's run Visual Studio Code and config its extension so we can go ahead with C++ code. First of all, I'm going to install C++ extension pack from Microsoft so we can have errors checking and autocomplete. Also going to install GLSL so we have something that help us writing shaders. And the Python extension, so if you need to run scripts to run the C++ code, sometimes I use it, so it's good for our toolkit. And now Visual Studio Code is almost completed configured. Because we have a problem, we can't call some visual we can't call Visual Studio Tools from the command prompt. As you can see in command prompt, the tool CMake didn't work, but in Visual Studio command prompt it works. It tells us that the instructions how to use CMake, and since the terminal from Visual Studio Code it is our command prompt, CMake will also not work. So we have to make something so we can put the developer command prompt from Visual Studio integrated with our Visual Studio Code. To make something like this. So first of all, we are going to hit Ctrl Shift P. We're gonna write terminal double dot create new terminal, we are going to create in the wheel, and we are I'm going to calling it C++ terminal. Now we're gonna hit Ctrl Shift P, terminal double dot configure terminal, so we can access the settings.json. You don't need this. And now we are going to copy a configuration that I will leave in the description. This configuration here. It's basically to run the Visual Studio Code command prompt. But we need the hits path. So let's open our Visual Studio command prompt so we can get hits path. And now we go to command 7, tools, and head is our Visual Studio command prompt. So we are going to copy this path. We are going to copy this path here. And we are going to replace these slashes with the counter slashes. And now we go ahead, we hit a new terminal. It is a command prompt, a normal command prompt, but we can select our C++ terminal, and CMake now works. Nice. We also want our terminal, our new terminal, being the default terminal. So when we hit terminal, new terminal, it opens already with our Visual Studio command prompt. Nice. Now that Visual Studio Code is ready for C++ development, let's create a Hello World project. Create a directory in your desktop called Hello World. Now let's open that folder. We are going to create a new file, main.c++, that I will write some code to show Hello World in the terminal. Don't worry about the error for now. Let's create also a build directory and a CMake list.txt. I'm going to write just some CMake configuration to run this simple project. And here we go. To compile and run this C++ code, we are going to go inside the build directory. We are going to write CMake dot dot. Now we are going to run msbuild helloworld.sln. And now we have our hello world executable, as you can see, inside debug folder. So we are going inside debug folder and execute helloworld.exe. And here it is, hello world. To make this error go away, we are going to hit Ctrl Shift P, CMake double dot quick configure, and we are going to scan for new kits. Yes, yes. And now we are going to choose Microsoft Visual Studio MD64, because my PC is 64-bit architecture. And the error is not here anymore, and we have autocomplete. Nice. And we also can do a cool stuff, that is hit the run button, and the project compiles and runs. Here it is, our hello world, just hitting a plate.